Felting. I purchased a pack of felting needles on Amazon. The T stands for triangle and will be the type we use, and the S stands for spiral. The numbers are the gauges of the needle, and the higher the number, the finer the needle. I started off with these three needles, but also ended up using the finer 42 gauge heavily. Your wool roving will come in a bundle like this, and you will need to tear a chunk off of it. Wool roving is where the wool fibers all go in the same direction. Wrap the wool around your character and begin poking it with a needle. Use your largest selection to begin with, then work your way down. This needle is working, but it is a bit too chunky, so I will quickly go down one size. It takes time to show progress, so be patient with this process. You will begin to see the material tangle itself together and tack onto the green foam. This is a side note. I didn't do this with my character and kind of regretted it. You can pre-tangle wool by placing it on your felting pad and poking it with your needle. In this case, I'm using a three-pronged felting tool. This will give your character's surface a smoother look. Mine came out looking a little stringy because I skipped this process. There is little else to be said about this process. Just keep poking until you have a solidified skin, then apply more wool and repeat. I will continue to show you this process in the video, but I don't have much to add to the visuals. Use the felting pad to anchor your puppet while felting. Use all angles of poking the needle in. This will create a smoother look. The fingers can be tricky, so watch carefully. I'm wrapping them in wool, then felting up the side before I tackle the tops of the fingers. I'm kind of folding the wool in like a burrito. That didn't work, so I'm starting over. Don't be afraid to start again if something isn't working. I'm taking some excess felt off with tiny scissors. The mini clover iron helps to bind the fibers into the direction you want them to go. It is a helpful tool, but not completely necessary for this process. I put the threaded rod in the foot while felting so I can make sure to have clearance for the tie down.